life of service, lived out in faith in you, comfort us and people around us in our sadness at her death. Following her example, help us to trust you for the good times, the tough times, and the days to come. May her soul rest in peace. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the King of love. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
I've just said that. So we'll stand, if we're able to remain standing, to sing 10,000 Reasons.
Worship His holy name. say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires met, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Would you like to sit or kneel as we come to a time of confession? My brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate the presence of Christ in word and sacrament, let us call to mind and confess our sins. We say together, Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We're going to now sing the Gloria together.
Of course, you don't have the books, so we're not doing the normal one because I don't have Terry. 966. Is all you need to do is repeat. You've done it before, I think. You just repeat, okay? Anyway, the choir have got it, so we can just do it, can't we? It'll be fine. Glory to God, glory to God. Glory to the Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Father. To him be glory forever, to him be glory forever. Alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen. Glory to God, glory to God, Son of the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, Son of the Father. To him be glory forever, to him be glory forever. Alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen. Alleluia, amen. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Spirit. Glory to God, glory to God, Son of the Spirit. To him be glory forever, to him be glory forever. Alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen, alleluia, amen.
Now the young people are going to go out to their groups. Just take a moment to pray for them now. We ask that the Lord will bless them and be with them as they prepare for our harvest. And so our special prayer for today, the Collect Prayer. Almighty God, you search us and know us. May we rely on you in strength. and rest on you in weakness, now and in all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
And now could we have our first reading, please?
The New Testament reading for today is taken from 1 Timothy 1, 12 to 17. I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who has given me strength, that he considered me trustworthy, appointing me to his service. Even though I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and a violent man, I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. The grace of our Lord was poured out on me abundantly, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. Here is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst. But for that very reason I was shown mercy, so that in me, the worst of sinners, Christ Jesus might display his immense patience as an example for those who would believe in him and receive eternal life. Now, to the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honour and glory for ever and ever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord.
We'd like to stand now if you are able, and we're going to sing There Is a Redeemer. It's 658 in the hymn book if you have one.
Thank you.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now the tax collectors and the sinners were all gathering around to hear Jesus, but the Pharisees and the teachers of the law muttered, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." Then Jesus told them this parable. Suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Does he not leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? And when he finds it, he joyfully puts it on his shoulders and goes home. Then he calls his friends and neighbours together, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my lost sheep." I tell you that in the same way, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who do not need to repent. Or suppose a woman has 10 silver coins and loses one. Doesn't she light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? And when she finds it, she calls over her friends and neighbours together and says, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my lost coin." In the same way, I tell you, there is rejoicing in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please take a seat. So why do we have two parables this morning, all mixed in together in one? Well, it's because the chief priests and the scribes were complaining about Jesus always being out partying. Are any of you always out partying? Neil's nodding. Yeah? Okay, good. Well, there's nothing wrong with a party, is there? But why were they celebrating? And was the party always instigated by Jesus? Was Jesus the host of the party? What do we think? Well, like I said, the important people were complaining about him because they saw that the Jewish person was out partying with the sinners, with the tax collectors and the unclean people. It's a celebration, isn't it? We should celebrate the fact that Jesus went out with sinners and tax collectors and ate meals with them and celebrated, because the other people didn't. The other people just said they were sinners. And that's the theme of this reading today. Two different parables with exactly the same theme. So we'll have a go at working through them. So start with the lost sheep, 100 sheep, which is a lot. If you've ever seen 100 sheep in one place, any of you seen 100 sheep in one place? Yeah? Anyone else? Yeah? It's a lot, isn't it? It's a lot of jumpers, that is. But if you had one sheep that was missing, would you know? If you had 100 in a field all together, would you know you had one missing? Probably not. Probably not. But what we've got to remember is those people in those days didn't have 100 sheep all to themselves. They would have been village members, they would have been family members, extended family members. All of those sheep would have been looked after by a couple of shepherds all together to keep costs down and things. Who's the shepherd? And when he goes off to find the lost one, what happens to the others? Are the others just left to fend for themselves? Or are the other ones already safe? It depends how you read the reading. It depends on where you come from, as I quite often say. We've got to assume there was always more than one shepherd. We quite often hear there was more than one. So we'll assume someone has stayed to keep the 99 safe, and one shepherd goes out to find the lost one. But who are the sheep? Are we sheep? Possibly. You could say we might be sheep, yeah? The sheep are the sinners, the lost in the world full of temptation. And I think we have just the same problem now, don't we? We have a lot of temptation around us, and it's really easy to get lost within the world we live. Now, when we find the sheep, or when God finds us, because God has found each and every one of us in our own unique ways, we'll have different stories of how God found us, or perhaps how we think we found God. But imagine the rejoicing that he would have had when he found us and brought us to his fold. The shepherd in this story is taking on the role of Jesus, isn't he? He's gone out to find those lost people, those sinners, those tax collectors, just the same way that Jesus always talks to the sinners and eats with the sinners, because that's the people he's trying to save. It's pointless eating with the important people if you want to save the other people. There's just no point. We know meals are very important in the Bible. We are told that we shouldn't give a meal to expect one back. So we shouldn't invite someone round to be expected to be invited back, because that's not how it works. We should joyfully ask someone to come round, to come and have what we have, to share in what we have. And if they don't have enough to invite us back, shouldn't worry us, and it doesn't worry us. Because of this, I think we have a story to tell, because we, like the shepherd, can be the people who go out to find the lost sheep. We could feel like we're one of the safe ones that don't feel able to step out to help find those lost sheep. I do hope that that's not the case. But like I said, I think we've all been lost at some point in our life, and we've all been found. Now, what about the woman and the coin? It's the same thing. You know, she has lost one silver coin. Now, that silver coin would have been really important. She may have been, I can't remember if the reading says that she was a widow or not, but it was possibly her dowry, so it was all she had, and this had to last her the rest of her life. So losing 10% of what you had is a huge thing. So she will have swept the house under the burning oil lamp to find what she was looking for. And yes, it may not be a sheep, but it's treasure. She's gone to find her treasure, the thing that's really important to her. Luke, interestingly, puts male and female together, which, you know, quite often we understand in the Bible that the female perspective is often left, and I don't necessarily agree with this female perspective either, because it assumes the woman is in the house and has lost a coin and is claiming to find it. I don't quite agree with that. But the principle is there. It includes male and female roles in this, which Luke is very good at doing. But maybe, just as an aside, that they put the woman looking for the coin because, well, women look at the details more than the men, don't they? They read the instructions more than the men, and they'll find the coin, whereas the man will go, I can't find it. That's true, isn't it? We all know that. Even I'm saying that's true. So the coin or the sheep, it's both the same thing. They've both rejoiced over finding what they lost by bringing something back together. What Jewish people of the day couldn't do was follow all the laws. They couldn't follow the laws. It was impossible for them to follow the laws and be people like Jesus, be the people that Jesus wanted them to be. So this is why Jesus eats, drinks, parties with the sinners, to allow other people that can't follow the laws for any reason to join in. Jesus says to us, you don't need to follow the law. You just need to be repentant. Ask for forgiveness, like we do at the beginning of every service. We ask for God to forgive our sins. Now, I wrote this before the events of Thursday, and since then I've kind of reflected on exactly what the Queen's role was for us. You know, she was the one that we would follow. We might watch the Queen's speech every Christmas. We're always interested when the things come on the telly. I don't think for a moment anyone's old enough to know life before the Queen, are they?
Yeah.
They all said no. I heard you all say no. Okay, you all said no. None of you are old enough. But, you know, she is that example. She is, perhaps, may I say, the Jesus of this time. We follow what she's done. We're now reflecting on a life that she's had, and in all her glory we now know where she will be. She wasn't the lost one, was she? She was the shepherd. She was the one that was going out to find. Now, I may have moaned in my house slightly about the repetitiveness of what's going on the television at the moment, haven't I? I have. But there are some really good snippets of things that have come out. You know, the Queen was very forward in thinking. She was already talking about, you know, Black Lives Matters and what was going on in the Commonwealth, and years before it ever really hit us. She was always very forward in thinking. And we can be like that also. We might not have quite the ability that the Queen had. We have our bodies and our brains and our tongues. And we can talk to people. We can tell people what it's like to be a Christian. We can outwardly show our faith just like she has. We can party with the sinners. We can help go and look for the lost. So as much as these readings follow on quite nicely from Sue's beautifully preached sermon last week, where it was, you know, leave your mother, leave your father, you know, they're dead to you. Now we hear something different, and this build-up will continue. And every time you hear a different set of readings, you need to reflect on what that means as you put them all together to become the life of Jesus, just like we're reflecting on the life of the Queen. So my thing to you today, my message, is to be the ones who go out, use what you have to go and find, to talk to help and to guide those people that are lost, because there are plenty of them around. Look around you, look at the number of empty seats. There are plenty of people that we need to go and find in our own unique and individual ways. Amen.
Stand now if you are able, as we declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven.
heaven and on earth is made. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Would you like to sit or kneel to pray as we have our prayers of intercession?
Looks like that'll be me then. Lord, we ask for you to be with us this morning in all of the things that we pray for, whether it be here in church or whether it be at home in our personal lives. Lord, we know that sometimes we feel your presence very strongly and sometimes we don't. But we know that you're always listening and always there with us. So I ask, Lord, that you be with us this morning in this time of prayer. When I say, God our shepherd, we say together, all our needs are known to you. Lord, we pray for the ones that we know that are less able than ourselves, those ones who struggle with the daily routines of life through mental, physical, or spiritual illnesses. We ask, Lord, that you heal where healing is possible. You give comfort where comfort is needed. Pray for Pat Oakes, Victoria Dixon, Ken Langton, Mary Brown, Mick and Yvonne Davis and family, Diane Brandrick Holt, June Goodwin, Dennis Lear, Farrah Hunter Coley, Pauline Duval, Tessa Pearson, Sue Coxon, Haya, Amy, Bob Boot, and Anne Smith, and anyone else that we know that is not on this list that we need to pray for this morning. God, our shepherd, all our needs are known to you. Lord, we pray for our benefice. We pray for our villages of Roaster, Denston, Hollington and Croxton. We pray that this time of shock and disbelief of the Queen's passing will be one of joyfulness eventually as we welcome a new King. Lord, we pray for our royal family who, although they mourn at the death of their mother, their grandmother, or their great-grandmother, we know, Lord, that they are in constant television view, where mourning for them is difficult. So as we reflect on her life throughout this next week, we pray for the rest of the royal family, their mourning, in their thinking of and in their acting with their new King. God, our shepherd, all our needs are known to you. Lord, we pray for those who have, the families of those who have gone before us. We pray for Margaret Podmore, who lived in this village. We pray for her family as they continue to think about the loss of a mother and a grandmother at this time of national mourning also. We ask, Lord, that you be with all who mourn at this time, no matter how long ago or how short a time it was. God our Shepherd, all our needs are known to you. Lord, we give you thanks also. We give you thanks for new beginnings, for new relationships, and to welcome other people into your family. And we pray this morning for the first wedding anniversary of Lee and Emily Walker, who were married here in this church. And also the first anniversary of a baptism of no relation, Chester James Higgs. We pray for them still in their ongoing relationship with you, and that their families are safe and well and flourishing. God, our Shepherd, all our needs are known to you. Lord, we just have a few moments of silence just to think about anything else on our hearts or in our heads that are heavy to us. We offer them up to you now. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. If you're able, would you stand as we share the peace with one another? Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, and with gratitude in your hearts sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Standing, if we're able, as we sing, I will sing the wondrous story.
Oh,
delight to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son.
You embraced us as your children, and welcomed us to sit and eat with you.
In Christ you shared our life that we might live in him, and he in us.
He opened his arms of love upon the cross, and made for all the perfect sacrifice for sin.
On the night that he was betrayed, at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life.
At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me."
Father, do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all.
As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit that this bread and this wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voices to join the eternal song of heaven.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
And as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share one bread.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Draw near with faith. Receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you. May it preserve your body and soul to everlasting life. Take and eat in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith and thanksgiving. Amen. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we, with the whole company of Christ, may sit and eat in your kingdom.
Set before us, so we and all your children shall be free.
which passes all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
St. Michael's Little Angels meet here. We will have to talk about Thursday. Okay, because I think you meet on a Thursday?
Tuesday.
Tuesday. And Thursday, that's what I thought. Anyway, afterwards we need to talk about Thursday.
Yeah.
Okay, because schools want to do lots of things this week to commemorate the Queen. So yes, please come along and bring any little ones you've got to that. You are more than welcome. Crafty, what are Crafty up to at the moment?
Making donkeys for the donkey
sanctuary. Full size? Okay, just thought I'd ask. Right, so making donkeys for the donkey sanctuary. That's Mondays at 1 till 3.
Yeah. Well,
right, so crochet and poppies for remembrance. Lovely, okay. We've got next. Men's shed, so there, I assume someone will still be here on Wednesday in Ian's absence. I think they did last week, so that continues to build. And I know they went to look at a porter cabin last Wednesday, so I'm sure we'll find out about that in due time. We are going to do something to celebrate the Queen. And we're having three services. I've done three, so hopefully you can come to one of them. So there's one this afternoon at 3 p.m. at St. Giles up in Croxton. There's one here on Wednesday, so that's this Wednesday coming, at 7 p.m. And there's also one at All Saints the day after on Thursday the 15th. They will all be relatively the same because I'm doing all three of them. So they will all be the same. If you're able to come to one, this will be our official commemoration to the Queen before her funeral next week. Okay. A fashion show, so we talked about that last week. So if you're able to come to that, Thursday the 22nd of September, 6:30 p.m.
7 o'clock.
6:30 p.m. I read that as Zoom. But it doesn't, does it? It says 7 p.m. There you go. That's because my poor eyesight. Okie dokie. So if you're able to come along to that, you're more than welcome. Coffee morning, that continues to go ahead as planned on the 24th of September, 10 till 12, and you can read their bacon butties and oat cakes and all of those things that St. Michael's are good at. So if you're able to come along to that to support, you're more than welcome to raise some money for cancer support. We continue to feed the hungry and take food to the food bank. From this morning, the food bank say, I'm just thinking of the notices at Denston, they don't need pasta and they don't need baked beans. Okay? Right? So tinned fruit, other tins, not pasta, not baked beans. So you must be inundated with those staples in life. Okay, next one, please. Right, so this is a bit small, but this will come up time and time again. The deanery are doing a leading worship course. You can see the dates on screen. I'll put them up on Facebook as well, and I'll probably get them put in the weekly sheet. It's about leading worship. It's about a bit of training, a bit of education of how to do it. So if anyone is interested to come along and learn from that, they're more than welcome to. I think it's all here actually, because we've got the bits and pieces, so it should be relatively easy. So that's that one. And there's another advertisement. So again, this is for the deanery. This is a first aid course. It's free to anyone who wants to go in and join. So I'm not not sure who are our first aiders here. Jill, just the one? Well, I need more than one, so get yourself on that course and become first aid trained. That would be my suggestion. Welcome to join that as well. If you want to donate for worship, you're more than
welcome.
Thank you, Ian. Ian? It's all falling apart now, isn't it? It's all falling apart. It's because you sat relatively where Ian would sit. I'm sorry, Neil. If you're able to donate for worship, please do so via the website or here in person. What have we got after this? Youth group, what have you been doing? Who's going to be brave and come and tell us? Come on, Patrick. Come on. Can remember, can't you? Good. Just check in.
So today we've just been preparing for harvest, for our harvest service performance, and we've just been doing poems and art works to show.
Okay. Last week, Richard had a poem as a demonstration. Do you have a poem as a demonstration?
No.
Somehow I just thought he'd say no. Any birthdays, anniversaries, or special occasions? Patrick's birthday this week. How old are you, Patrick? 15, I remember it well.
Garry, Little Angel's
14th
birthday on Friday.
Little Angel's 14th?
14th, yeah.
14th birthday 14th. On Friday. Wow, okay. Any others? Any other birthdays? So should we sing happy birthday to Little Angels and Patrick? I won't embarrass you again, Patrick. So, happy birthday to you, to Jesus be true. May God's richest blessing be always with you. Now, we have the final hymn, and then straight after we'll go into the National Anthem. And you're to sing straight away, because that's the version I've picked. Okay? The words are on the screen, and of course they're changed to King and He and Him. Okay? So after this piece of music, after this final hymn, we'll go straight into the next one. Thank you, Richard.
Thank you.
go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.